My name's Christina. I'm 34, and I have a daughter. She's 13, and it's just the two of us. My parents divorced when I was 2. My mom remarried when I was 4 to my stepdad. It was fine until I turned 11. I started having panic attacks from that age. There was a lot of physical abuse and mental abuse. Because of that and the anxiety, I ran away when I was 11. I lived with my grandparents for 4 years until there was sexual abuse. And then I went back to my parents for 6 weeks. My mother told me she didn't love me and to get out of the house. So I had nowhere to go other than the streets. And then when I got pregnant at 19, she kind of stepped up to the plate a little. She helped me a lot with raising Katrina when she was little. And then 5 years ago, she decided that she needed to follow her husband to Edmonton for a new job. And it shattered my world. I had no other family left. Tried to rely on my two best friends, but they couldn't handle the psychotic breakdown that I was having. So they left, and I was completely alone. And that's when I lost my daughter.
My name is Sarah. I'm from Vancouver. I'm a single mom with 3 children. Their ages are 19, 13, and 4. Well, I grew up downtown Vancouver with my mom, a single mom, and my brother. When I was 12 years old, I was a victim of rape. That changed my life. I had a lot of shame and a lot of guilt for many years and didn't tell anybody. Kept it inside. I was bullied at school a lot. So that was very hard, and it forced me to quit school in grade 8. I think that led to a lot of my addiction struggles, trying to kind of self-medicate and let go of that trauma. Crystal meth went from being something that I felt was okay to destroying my whole life in a matter of 6 months. But heroin was harder. It became a way to not feel that pain anymore. And you know that it's making you sick, and it's making, I don't know, it's just taking away so much from your life, but you can't stop, even though you're scared. And every time I used, I had this fear that I was gonna die. I didn't wanna die. I stayed away from my children because I didn't want them to have that in their lives. It destroyed a lot of things. I was 3 months pregnant with my daughter when I found out that I was pregnant. I had a crystal meth and heroin addiction at the time and was living in an SRO downtown by myself. I was alone and didn't have much contact with my family at the time. It was probably the scariest moment of my life, knowing that I had no way to support myself, a child, knowing that I already had 2 other children that were in the care of my mother. I didn't know what was gonna come next. I didn't know, my only thought was, if I lose this child, if I can't be there to take care of her, I'm never gonna get out of here. I'm always gonna be here, and it's gonna hurt. And I know how much I love my children. And just the thought of that was my driving force. And it was hard, and went into the hospital not knowing if they were gonna take my baby or not when I got there. It was very, very scary.
Part of getting Katrina back was to go to counseling. And the therapist there suggested the why. And so I started going to the why to get help. And I met other women who were going through situations that I was going through that also lost their kids. And we're struggling to try to get them back, and we're struggling with mental health issues. And it gave me hope that I could come back from this and remake myself into a new person, because I lost the person I was before. The YWCA Single Moms Group gave me a place to go. Granted, I didn't really talk for the first year and a half, but I was able to listen. And I listened to other moms that were going through the same things that I was going through. And it gave me hope that I could get my daughter back and that I could overcome the mental illness that I was diagnosed with.
I was encouraged by one of the outreach workers to come to the YWCA and connect with the people here and the housing workers, because I definitely needed a safe place to go. The moment I walked through the doors and started talking to the staff, I felt so comfortable. Just like I knew that this was going to be the place that was going to help me. My first contact would have been with Benita, and she runs the housing at Crabtree. And, you know, having support there made all the difference in the world. Like, having just one person say to me, you got this, Sarah. You can do this. Like, it's all up to you, you know? And like, we'll be there, whatever you need, but really it's all you. So if you want to do it, you can do it. So I've been clean now since the day I gave birth, and it's completely changed my life, how I think about things now. Like, my children always come first. And my daughter Abby, she's 4, Abby Lynn, and she's currently in daycare here at Crabtree, and will be starting kindergarten in September, which is huge. I'm looking at my next steps in life to be able to help my family and support them. To be able to go home and have a second chance to rebuild my relationship with them, it's made such a huge difference. And, you know, that feeling now, to have that, to let go of that, I feel so free. I recently put in my resume to apply for the co-facilitator for the FASD group here. Whether or not that's going to lead to anything, I don't know, but it gave me the confidence to do that. I really want to work with women and children and families, especially ones that have come through addiction or poverty. I think that's where I can support people the most.
Dear Christina.
Dear Sarah, I know you feel lost. I felt it before.
I know it seems bleak right now. You have lost everyone and everything, your family, your friends, and most of all your daughter, who is the most important part of who you are. This is what I want you to know. Today you are broken, the pieces of your life shattered around you. How do you begin again?
I want to let you know, it's going to be okay. Reaching out to the YWCA will be the turning point you are looking for. They are here to help build you up, strengthen you, and support you when you need it.
It's okay that you're scared.
Don't be afraid.
Take your time. They're not going anywhere. These women will become your lifeline and reconnect you to the world again.
The future is bright, and you have all the opportunity to be a positive force in this world.
They will help you pick up the pieces of your life and put the puzzle back together again. It may not look the same, but because of them, it's going to be so much better.
Your struggles will be your strengths.
Hang in there, Christina.
Love, Sarah.